Hello, welcome to a coding challenge entitled 4D Open Simplex Noise Loop. That's got to be like a clickbait title if I ever heard one, right? Anyway, let me thank somebody. The artist Etienne Jacob, who I've referred to in like the last 307 coding challenge videos that I've made because I keep doing this topic over and over again, has been really an inspiration for these videos, makes these amazing noise loop GIFs, and I've talked a little bit about some techniques for doing that using classic Perlinoise, the noise function in processing, which you can also refer to as fractal noise. And I've recently, through feedback and research, been turned on to this idea of simplex noise and open simplex noise, and I made an entire video all about that and the differences and a little bit about the history there, so I'll refer you to that video if you want to find out more. In this particular video, all I'm going to do is I now have the processing 3D noise example, which you'll see nothing is three-dimensional here. There's really a two-dimensional space of noise, and the third dimension is what's creating the animation. Frame, you can think of that third dimension almost as time. I'm seeing frame by frame by frame. What I want to do with this is take this and make it loop. I want to have this noisy scene, and this is using open simplex noise, which has a different quality and character to it. It has less what are known as directional artifacts that I referred to in the previous video as like this herky jerky feeling of what kind of the noise algorithm could sometimes do. It feels to like stop and turn around. And so the smoothness of this is quite pleasant and has a kind of visual quality that's, for a lot of scenarios, better. So there's more to say about that. You could go watch the other video. But what I want to do is make this run just over a few seconds and then render it as a GIF that loops seamlessly. I took a quick break there just to render out that processing sketch. I rendered it out like a few seconds. And as you'll see, I rendered it to a GIF. And every few seconds, you see this sort of jarring thing happen where it goes back to the beginning. The last frame of this noisy scene doesn't match the first frame. And this is something that I talked about in previous coding challenge videos, how to get a sequence of values, a one-dimensional array of random values where the last value matches up with the first. You close that loop. And the way that I did that was I want one dimension of values. Let me walk around a circle, a circular path in a 2D noise space. So now, what we're doing is I want two-dimensional looping values. So I need to basically walk around the space of a torus, right? I need all of these values to move around and like come on back. So first, what I want to do is, so this is, let me just be clear, this is the processing noise 3D example, and the only thing changed is I've added this open simplex noise code from Kurt Spencer. I will link to where that code and some background about this open source implementation, where it comes from, in the video's description. And instead of calling processing's noise function, I'm calling noise.efal from Kurt Spencer's Open Simplex Noise, and that gives me a double, so I have to convert that into float, and also gives me a range of values between -1 and 1, which is different than the values between 0 and 1. Okay, so what I would like to do, though, however, is make this a bit more visually obvious what's going on. So I'm going to change this. I'm going to threshold this to render the color either black or white. And one way I can do that is with a nice little ternary expression. I can say brightness equals, like, is noise greater than 0? If the noise value that comes out is greater than 0, then I want to see 255. Otherwise, I want to see 0. So if I do that, you'll see we get this. And I can kind of play with the sort of increment values, like maybe let me make the increment a little less, but make it go through the Z space faster. I don't know. So now we can see. So this would be a bad, I should have rendered this to a GIF so you could see it not looping, but this is what I want to have loop. And also, look at the beauty of this particular noise algorithm. It's very smooth. It doesn't feel like it's sort of, it doesn't have that directional artifact. It doesn't feel like it's sort of slowing down to a stop and then going backwards. It just keeps going with this kind of beautiful organic randomness. All right, so now that I have this, let's turn this into a GIF loop. All of these videos are now kind of this series, everything's depending on each other. So I did have a previous coding challenge where I made processing code that just renders out the frames for a GIF loop. And at demonstration, it's just a rotating square. So what I want to do is I'm going to use that as my basis. Let me grab the all of the code before setup from here, which is all of this. I'm going to put that into my GIF loop code. Then I want to make the new OpenSimplex noise object. And I'm going to put that in here. Now it's complaining to me. It doesn't know what OpenSimplex noise is. So I do need to make a new tab. I'm going to call it OpenSimplexNoise.java. It needs to be .java because this particular OpenSimplex noise class is using some features of the Java programming language that don't work super elegantly in processing. So I can then just go copy and paste it over. You know, certainly there's more streamlined ways of importing a Java class, but just copying it over is one way. Then I'm going to come back to here. And what I'm going to do is everything that's in draw is what should go into this render class, this render function. So this render function should now have all of the drawing code. All right, so here now we have this running. Now it's not looping yet. I've got to figure that out. I want to give myself more frames probably. And actually, let's make it short because I really want to make sure it's looping. Let's make it 640 by 360. It's kind of nice to have that aspect ratio. Okay. So now this is what I want to render as a perfect loop. So what's going on? Okay. So here's the thing. The thing that needs to loop is the z-axis. The z-axis, instead of moving forward in time, should move around in a circular path to create that donut in three-dimensional space. So how do I do that exactly? Well, it turns out that the way that I can do that is let me actually get rid of this idea of z offset, and I want to have the, let's see if I can diagram this. All right, so this is my two-dimensional plane of noise in three-dimensional space, I'm at any given point, what I want to do is kind of walk around in a circle. And if this were the flat plane, the circle would come out like this. I don't know if this is real. So what I need is an angle. I need to rotate around. I need to use that polar coordinate formula to rotate around a circular path within one plane of the three-dimensional space. So to do that, I use four-dimensional noise because what I'm doing here is remember, in looping a GIF, I want a percentage from 0 to 100%. So I can now have an angle which is equal to map that percent from 0, which goes between 0 and 1, to between 0 and 2 pi. Then I can have, I'm going to call this like U offset for the third dimension, and I'm going to call this a V offset for the fourth dimension. And so what those are is I'm going to say cosine of the angle and sine of the angle, right? So I'm going to use the polar to Cartesian coordinate transformation and map these values, which go between 0 and 1. No, sorry, go between negative 1 and 1 to between some noise radius, some noise diameter. This is a concept I talked about in the previous looping video, but it's very hard to type and talk at the same time. Sometimes I do a good job, sometimes I'm a mess, and right now I'm a mess because this is very hard to explain. So this is exactly the same technique that I did in the first noise loop video where I just had an X and a Y. Now I have an X and a Y, but the looping is happening in the U and the V. So that's where the size of this circle is important. So I'm not sure whether I in the OpenSimplex noise algorithm if I can have negative values or not, but to be safe, I'm just going to like map these between like 0 and 2. So that's somewhat, I'm picking sort of an arbitrary, this I think we called noise diameter or something like that. I'm picking an arbitrary value. Now, down here, change this to U offset, V offset, and let's run this. Did I get everything right? No. Oh, I have an extra zero in here because I'm going crazy. I don't have, Z offset is not a thing anymore, and here we go. Okay, so one thing to note here is that 4D, the implementation for getting 4D noise is quite slow. And you can see this frame rate sort of like chugging along. The good news for us is we're here to render out to a loop. So I don't care about the speed, the frame rate. I am just going to turn record to true, and I'm going to run this again, and I will see you when it finishes rendering. All right, it finished rendering. So here, the good news, just to reiterate, because 3D noise worked quite smoothly, if you're not rendering out to a loop, you don't need that fourth dimension. You could just use the third dimension and watch your real-time software in your media art installation work beautifully. But if I'm rendering it out, I want to close that loop, I do need that fourth dimension. Okay. I'm going to switch over to my terminal window, and I'm in the GIF loop 4D sketches folder, and now I'm going to use FFmpeg to render all those frames into a GIF. So I'm going to say FFmpeg -f image 2, and FFmpeg is a utility you would have to install separately. I'll include a link to how to do that in this video's description. -f image 2 -frame rate, let's give it 30 frames per second. -i, the file path, which is output, GIF, it's each file is GIF dash and then a number, so 0, 3 digits dot png, and then I'll call it noise loop dot GIF, and I'm going to render that out. I am going to take a look at it. Here it is. Let's take a look. And by golly, if that doesn't loop, I don't know what loops. Right, this is about 4 seconds long. So, of course, you can see, you might be able to detect the loop because it's so short, but if I made it a little longer and if there was a bit more, if I was more artistic and had more creative ideas about how to vary the visual quality, you might be able to create something more like what I showed you in those original Etienne Jacob GIFs.
Hi, so this might be the strangest, most non-traditional ending of a coding training video ever, because you probably were just watching me in the studio coding, but I was gonna record a new ending to it today in the studio, but it's a snow day. Buried in snow here, can barely walk. Anyway, what you have just seen is a coding challenge where I added OpenSimplex noise. Really, I think what you should take away from this is the quality of OpenSimplex noise rather than classic Perlin noise, and think about the kinds of projects you might make that run in real time that don't actually need to loop. But if you're making a looping GIF, this is sort of an interesting technique. I'm gonna show you right now also this terrain. This is basically my coding challenge before, but with OpenSimplex noise instead of classic Perlin noise. That's a challenge to you. If you can make this looping terrain happen, then try that. But I'm gonna do it in a video. I'll come back this Wednesday during my regular live stream, and I will create this terrain with OpenSimplex noise as a follow-up video. Hope you enjoyed this short coding challenge with OpenSimplex noise and looping in four dimensions and all sorts of wackiness like that. And I'll see you next time on the coding train. Choo-choo!